Hello friends, welcome to Obipedia. We have started series on disputed islands. We have covered around 7 or 8 disputed islands. Today we'll cover disputed island Abu Musa and Greater Tums. Just to recap, what is disputed island? Disputed island is that part of land over which there is dispute between two or more countries or entities over the possession of that land. And what may be the cause of dispute? There are many causes like natural resources, rivers, cultural, religious, or vague agreements. And what these disputes can lead to? These can lead to war, terrorism, and rise of non-state entities. You must have seen that Kashmir's dispute between India and Pakistan, and there we have witnessed war. There we have witnessed rise of non-state entities. Non-state entities are those entities which do not have any power, but they want to be major decision maker in the settlement of that dispute. We have seen rise of terrorism, war like Kargil war in 1999. Next, what UN says? According to UN, every nation must try to avoid war and should not work against the territorial integrity or political independence of any other country. Now we'll cover Abu Musa and Greater Tums. Abu Musa, this is dispute between Iran and UAE. This is basically a group of three islands. You can see the location. It is located in Persian Gulf, group of three islands, Greater Tums, Lesser Tums, and UAE and Abu Musa. First, Abu Musa, second, Greater Tums, third, Lesser Tums. Location in Persian Gulf, and size is of around 5 square kilometers. Every size is 5 square kilometers. These are very small islands, but very important. Why dispute? They are very rich in oil resources. Secondly, they are rich in red iron oxide. Third, you can see the location of these islands, that all ships passing through Persian Gulf, they pass between Abu Musa and Greater Tums and Lesser Tums. What does it mean? That those countries or those powers which have control over on these islands, they can stop the ship transit in and out from that Persian Gulf. This is so strategically important. 20% of the oil resources, world oil resources, come from these islands. Secondly, this island provides sort of security to Iranian port Bandar Abbas. And thirdly, it has got oil refinery and army base. What I mean to say that these islands are very important as they are rich resources of oil. Secondly, way to port Bandar Abbas. Thirdly, oil refinery and military base. Fourthly, transit in and out of ships passing through Persian Gulf. These are so important. And this is a dispute between Iran and UAE. What is the recent history? Arab Emirates, before 1968, it was colony of Britain. It got independence in 1971. It was decided that this Abu Musa would be divided between Iran and UAE. in 1971 it was divided. What it means that the joint responsibility of the maintenance of this island, Abu Musa, joint responsibility, would be between Iran and UAE. Joint responsibility means responsibility of defense, economy. Economy wise means the oil which was taken out of Abu Musa oil refineries, the capital, the income, the profits would be divided between Iran and UAE. And as I have earlier said, that 20% of the world oil comes through these islands. These islands, they are so strategically important. As the joint responsibilities between Iran and UAE, Iran sent army forces for the maintenance of these islands in the same way UAE also sent. But what led to dispute? As Iran sent army forces, Iran tried to occupy full part of Abu Musa Islands, means that part of island which was under UAE. Secondly, Iran occupied nearby islands, greater terms and lesser terms. Iran occupied illegally greater terms and lesser terms. And what is the claim held by Iran to occupy these islands? According to Iran, the history goes back to BC period, means there was one tribe, Arb Qasmi, which ruled over Tuns, and they were subject of Iran, means they were not independent. They were ruling these islands. This Qasmi tribe was ruling this island and it was subject of Iran. They were not independent. Iran further held that the island Abu Musa was under Emirate of Sharjah and the islands of Terms was under Ras Al Khaimah. Ras Al Khaimah and Emirates, they were two countries which were occupying these two islands. And as they were not independent states, so they do not possess any rights over these islands. It's obvious that to possess right over particular part of a land, particular island or particular country, one must be independent country. As Ras Al Khaimah and Emirates, they were not independent countries. Their rights over islands, terms and Abu Musa were not legal. And in the same way, UAE also claim. UAE, according to UAE, it is believed that these islands, Abu Musa and Terms, they were occupied by Qasmi tribe. And Qasmi tribes, they belong to Arab countries. They were not part of Iran. Even presently, in present times, this Qasmi tribe is Arabic tribe, not Iranian tribe. This Arabic character of tribe led these UAE or sideways countries to occupy or to have control over these islands. Secondly, UAE claims that greater terms, they were illegally occupied by Iran because Ras Al Khaimah did not agree to any settlement of these islands between Iran and Ras Al Khaimah. And UAE agreed under pressure for the division of Abu Musa. What basically it means that the Abu Musa island was divided between Iran and UAE under pressure. Iran forced UAE king to divide this island, and the rulers of greater terms and lesser terms did not agree to division, so they were illegally occupied by Iran by force. Now, dispute settlement. This dispute is going on. For the settlement of this dispute, four Arabian countries, Iraq, Libya, Algeria and Yemen. Iraq, Libya, Algeria and Yemen. Referred this matter to International Court of Justice and United Nations Security Council. But United Nations Security Council deferred this matter to later date. Reason being, according to United Nations Security Council, this matter before referring to ICJ should be settled amicably or by third party. If it is not settled by third party or amicably, then it should be referred to ICJ. For matter referring to ICJ, International Court of Justice, both countries should agree. UAE wants to refer it to ICJ, but Iran does not agree. Hence, it cannot be referred to ICJ. The present status is this matter is under dispute. They are trying to sort it out, but Iran is not agreeing to sort it out amicably. Why is dispute? This is dispute due to strategic location. Secondly, oil resources, rich iron oxide, and lastly, this is way to port Bandar Abbas. I hope you understood this dispute. Next, we'll come out with another disputed island. Kindly share this video. Thank you.